Hey, we're Primitive Weapons, and you're getting your fix of metal injection.
What's up? We're Primitive Weapons. We're hanging out in Brooklyn, New York. We're about to check out some of our favorite bars, which we all happen to own. Hello. My name is Chris Enriquez. I am the drummer from Primitive Weapons, and we were hanging out at Montana's Trail House in Bushwick, New York. As you can see, my bandmates are here. We spend a lot of time here. Montana and I met maybe about close to 15 years ago when I started hanging out in Brooklyn. He was one of my first bartenders. A lot of us grew up around the New York hardcore scene, and I think that in the years of playing in bands, part of our responsibility is actually entertaining people, showing people a good time, and I kind of see this restaurant as an extension of that.
You start as a bartender, a waiter, and then it kind of evolves, and now we're just getting to be old and fatter, and now we're just,
there you go,
running our own crew and, putting out records still, but also just doing the restaurant and bringing people great product.
It only was natural as we got older to come together and try to build our own place. This actually used to be an old gas station slash mechanic shop, and as you can see, things have changed. And
still pretty greasy, though.
We're pretty proud of what we were able to accomplish here. So this bookcase actually does open up into a storage area.
Torture chamber.
Got a nice view of the neighborhood out here. There are metal bands that play here every year in a warehouse that's part of this block party we do. My favorite memories are actually our holiday parties where we're able to have people from different bands and bars come in, hang out, and we just fucking sing songs until about 4 o'clock in the morning and go nuts. Like, if anybody is ever around July 4th in Brooklyn, we really go to town and people fucking party.
Hey, what's up, guys? This is Eric from Primitive Weapons. We are here hanging out in my bar in Brooklyn called Lake Street, which I opened with a bunch of friends of mine from the Midwest. We needed a place to watch the Minnesota Vikings, so we said, let's do that. Put up a bunch of TVs for Sundays to watch football and listen to some good music. For the thing that we do here, it kind of brings in a little bit older crowd, so we don't get, drunk 21-year-olds too often that don't know how to hold themselves. The overall vibe was a Midwest kind of thing. Play cool music and have as many people as we could work from the Midwest. Like, the half our staff is Minnesotan. Also, just like the products we carry, we try to get as many Midwest beers as we could. It's not that easy. My favorite memory here was when our friends Babes in Toyland from Minnesota came. I'm in a band with Bobby and Frank. We played down at St. Vitus with Babes in Toyland, and then we came and partied here afterwards. And it was kind of why we did this bar, was to put where we came from kind of on the map over here.
Hey, what's up? I'm Artie.
I'm Dave.
This is St. Vitus.
After being in the band for a while, Artie was exploring the idea of, with George, who was like his bartending, star-tending partner in crime. And so this is, this is going to be their place. We had kind of no idea that shit was going to kind of happen the way that it did, I was asked to bartend Tuesday nights and book a couple of shows. And, it just happened really organically amongst friends, and a love of common musical history,
I basically saw what Dave had done with the band, with our EP and stuff, and like how much attention we had gotten in the shows we were getting on, and I was like, hey, he'd be great to book our new place, that'd be awesome. So that was kind of where it came from. It just made sense. At the time, we didn't think we were going to be doing full-time venue stuff, so but eventually, we told him, create your own position, and he did. I would have never thought we would have made it to 5 years. I mean, it's
not to this level, for
no,
sure,
and certainly not to this level. But the room sounds great, and it looks great, and a lot of people really enjoy playing here, and we enjoy doing it, so it's fine.
I think also like it's become like such a conduit for a lot of stuff. Like a lot of people contribute to this success of the entire place.
I couldn't be more appreciative of all the people that have supported us. You, Frank, and
Metal Injection.
You know, and, yeah, and you know, everybody else who's been so awesome to us, and we all need each other. You know, like if we didn't have each other, things would be, I think, way shittier, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. It's cool. I mean, I think it's like a New York style rock club, which I think that there's like, you know, like you know, if you're in a band, you take your influences from your CBGBs, your L'Amours, your
Limelights,
you know, Coney Island High, you know?
This room just sounded too good to not utilize properly. And yeah, that's kind of where things developed, and we, you know, over the years, just decided to keep going and doing it and doing it. And the shows just kept getting better and bigger and awesome.
Thanks for coming out with us today here in Brooklyn. Montana's Trail House, Lake Street, St. Vitus, all good times. Our record comes out on April 15th through Party Smasher, Inc. And pick it up.